The first crash test in the history of Mercedes-Benz took place on 10 September 1959, when a test car was accelerated head-on towards a stationary obstacle. Safety research at the brand just entered a new era. Hello and welcome to Carholic. Please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons. From now, the behavior of vehicles and occupants in car accidents could be investigated in realistic circumstances using test cars and crash test dummies. 1939 was a key year in the history of safety at the Stuttgart brand, for this was the year Daimler-Benz signed up the engineer Béla Barényi. His developments were to prove definitive in terms of passive safety for the modern passenger car. The new inventions included the safety body with rigid passenger cells and front and rear crumple zones, premiered in 1959 in the W111 series, and the safety steering wheel, which made its debut in 1976 in the 123 series. The new improvements developed the safety body to production standard in the 1950s. The crumple zones, which were designed to absorb kinetic energy of a crash by controlled deformation. The prevailing view at the time was still that the interests of occupants' safety were best served by maximum rigidity of the body. The new W111 series was the first to benefit from preliminary vehicle safety tests conducted by the engineers. Although there were as yet no crash tests in the precise sense of the term, the company's own researchers had already begun testing individual vehicle components for their behavior in accidents since 1960. As far as component testing was concerned, the engineers focused initially on parts from the vehicle interior. In so doing, they were able to apply existing methods used by the glazing industry, where a few years earlier a simulator had been developed to study the behavior of safety glass. This was used to simulate the impact of a human head against the front windscreen. Gradually, the engineers used the dummy head to test other components of the vehicle interior. Such tests showed the dangers not only in protruding components but also in wooden trim, which had a tendency to splinter. However, since many customers, in particular those buying luxury class models, preferred genuine wood as a material for interior equipment, Mercedes-Benz developed a multi-layered composite material in which the wood was prevented from splintering by aluminum inserts. The development of the safety belt in the late 50s also called for a reliable testing procedure for this new restraint system in vehicles. The solution developed in 1959 was the test sled, originally suspended so that it could be swung with acceleration against a fixed object. The technology used for these crash tests was also constantly improved. To begin with, for example, a winch was used to accelerate the cars since this could not be done under the power of their own engines. The engineers borrowed winching technology used by the glider pilots to launch their aircraft. At Mercedes-Benz, however, the tow was used to launch brand new saloons so that when they took off from the so-called corkscrew ramp at speeds of 75 to 80 km, they rolled over in the air. In 1962, the company designed a hot water rocket that powers the vehicles without the use of a tow line. Reinforced concrete was used for the runway, and the test vehicles and the propulsion system were now guided on rails. The great advantage of crash tests over crashed vehicle analysis lay in the opportunities this offered to record the actual events of the crash test in every detail. The necessary technology to do so had been developed in the years prior to 1959. This included the use of acceleration sensors fitted to the dummies and the test car itself, as well as high-speed film that could reproduce images in extreme slow motion for purposes of collision analysis. The use of simulation dummies ensured very conclusive results, since the dummies were equipped with capsules for recording acceleration. The first ever dummy used was named Oscar and remained the only test dummy used for early crash testing in Sindelfingen. Front seat passengers were simulated more often using sandbags or shop window mannequins. Even when other more advanced test dummies were acquired later, Oscar continued to provide invaluable service. Indeed, this first ever test dummy went on to serve the Stuttgart brand's safety research department for 3 decades.